And welcome everyone to our second, oh my gosh, anniversary cabaret. My name is Tabitha Jablonski, and we are so excited to have some performances for you tonight. Some of them are live, some of them are Smule, and it's just nice to look back down memory lane. Obviously, our second year wasn't as crazy as our first one, but I'm actually thankful for that because we all had more stuff going on in our regular lives, which is so great. But even though it wasn't as intense, we still did a whole lot of readings for the past year, considering that things started opening back up. And I was just looking at the list of shows we did, and I think we did pretty well. So it was a lot of fun shows. We had some awesome guest directed shows. We had some incredible shows like Les Mis and A Chorus Line, which I never would have thought we would ever do virtually. So it's just insane. And I'm so excited to go through memory lane with you guys. Technically, our anniversary is tomorrow, but we can't have this tomorrow because your girl's in a real live rehearsal for a real live theater show. So yay. So that's why we're celebrating it today. But April 5th, 2020 is when our group was created on Facebook. And of course, the rest is history. And we've developed such an amazing group of friends. And I'm so excited to get to see some of them perform, even on Smule or live. Some of these people I haven't seen in a while. So it's just nice to reconnect with all of you guys. The first performance we have is a Smule. It's one of, I'm going to say that about all of them, but it's true. Okay, it's one of my favorite ones that we've done, A Chorus Line, which was so cool. And it actually worked really well as a show that is dancing, but it honestly worked very well virtually. And we had an incredible cast for that. And that was only a couple of months ago. So that was a really exciting reading. So Alexandra Faye submitted At the Ballet, which is an amazing song featuring three amazing performers. So here we have a Smule. Let me just get it queued up. Here we have a Smule featuring Alexandra Faye, Sarah Sider, and Erica White performing At the Ballet from A Chorus Line. So please enjoy.
Daddy always thought that he married beneath him. That's what he said. When he proposed, he informed my mother he was probably her very last chance. And though she was 22, she married him. Life with my dad wasn't ever a picnic, more like a come as you are. When I was 5, I remembered my mother, dog earrings out of the car. They weren't hers, but I knew that it wasn't something you'd want to discuss. He wasn't warm. Well, not to her. Well, not to us. But everything was beautiful at the ballet. Graceful men lift lovely girls in white. Yes, everything was beautiful at the ballet. Hey, I was happy at the ballet. That's when I started class. Up a steep and very narrow stairway to the voice like a metronome. Up a steep and very narrow stairway. It wasn't paradise, but it was home.
Mother always said I'd be very attractive when I grew up. Different, she said, with a special something and a very, very personal flair. And though I was eight or nine, I hated her. Now, different is nice, but it sure isn't pretty. Pretty is what it's about. I never met anyone who was different, who couldn't figure that out. so beautiful I'd never lived to see. But it was clear, not to her, well then to me, that everyone is beautiful at the ballet. Every prince has got to have his swan. Yes, everyone is beautiful at the ballet. I was pretty.
Metronome up a steep and very narrow stairway.
It wasn't paradise,
but it was home.
I don't know what they were for or against, really, except each other. I was born to save their marriage, but when my father came to pick my mother up at the hospital, he said, well, I thought this was going to help, but I guess it's not. Anyway, I did have a fantastic fantasy life. I used to dance around the living room with my arms up like this. In my fantasy, it was an Indian chief. And he'd say to me, Maggie, do you want to dance? I'd say, Daddy, I would love to dance.
Do, do, do.
Love that song. Thank you, Marvin Hamlisch, for that song. And thank you, Alexandra, for that awesome Smule. The three of you did incredible, not just in that Smule, but in the whole show. But it was great to watch you guys again. All right, up next, we have Robert Howard, who sent in a Smule of a solo he did for our reading of The Prom, which was guest directed by Michelle Moses Eisenstein, and it's We Look to You from The Prom. So The Prom was super fun. Michelle was excited to do that show for a while, and she was finally able to do it this past September. So I'm really excited to show a performance from that reading. So again, Robert Howard performing We Look to You from The Prom.
My days have little glamour, writing memos, making calls, and wincing at the grammar written on the bathroom walls. It's all school supplies and budget size and wading through red tape. That's why I love the theater. It's how I escape. We look to you to take us away from the soul-crushing jobs and emasculating pay. When our lives come up short and our hopes are sad and few, you whisk us off to someplace strange and new. We look to you in good times and bad. The worlds you create make the real ones seem less sad. The curtain goes up, and every now and then it feels as if we're coming home again. Yes, coming home again. We need a place to run to when everything goes wrong, where the answer to each problem is to burst into a song. And standard rules of logic just simply don't apply when people dance in unison and no one wonders why. We look to you, as strange as it seems, when reality goes to scary new extremes. So don't ever give up, and this I guarantee. Next time you think that no one cares, you can look to me.
That smile at the end, Robert. Thank you so much for that performance from the prom. And I don't know, I was just listening to it and it made me think about how it's talking about how we look to performers when life is too hard. And that's basically what this group has been, at least to me, these past 2 years. That's how I feel about all of you guys when life was really, really difficult. Just looking at you guys and the Smules and the performances, it just gave me hope. And even now, even though we're not necessarily all shut up in our homes like we used to be, life can still get hard and stressful. And it's just important to have this amazing group to go back to. And just, we do it just because we love it. We don't even have an audience over here, at least a live audience. And it's just people who love musical theater and love just getting together once in a while and just having fun and expressing our love and making life a little bit nicer, when especially if you're going through a hard time. And it was a little easier, I feel like, the first year, because everyone was going through a hard time. But something we need to remember is that we never know who's going through a hard time. Even when it looks like the world is better, we might still need each other once in a while. So it's good to have amazing people like all of you guys to lean back on. So thank you, Robert, for giving me that warm hug in your performance. So thank you. All right, up next, we have our first live performance for the evening. It's actually from our most recent reading. Hey, it's Amanda Jones, who was our amazing pseudolist like a week ago or a week. Yeah, a week ago. And it was so much fun to watch her. Oh, you're wearing our t-shirt.
I am. It's our winter one.
Yeah. And she was just incredible to watch. She was just so funny. And you're just amazing in everything. But that was one of my favorite performances of you, like in general, just because it was so much fun to watch you as Subelis. So Amanda will be performing Free. Amanda, do you want to talk a little bit about why you picked that song? And
Absolutely. Yes. Yeah. So I told everybody who was in the cast, but I was in like a dinner theater performance of this for like 6 months straight in high school. And I was one of the Gemini twins. And it's like the most boring show to be like a female chorus member in. And then you have all these guys with all these amazing roles. So it was super fun. I'd always wanted to just do one of these like meteor roles, but they're so funny. It's like the show that, I mean, I watched this movie 5,000 million times, like, and just always laugh at it. So very exciting.
Well, I'm excited for more people to see it. I see your performance of it. So take it away, Amanda.
All righty. Here we go. It died on me, hold on. Smeal completely crashed on me. One second, guys.
Oh, Smeal. I liked you the drama of your face beforehand, though. You were ready.
Free. Oh, what a word. Oh, what a word. Say it again.
Free.
I often thought, I often dreamed how it would be. And yet I never thought I'd be. Oh, once again.
Free.
But when you come to think of such things, a man should have the rights of all others. Can you imagine what it would be like when I am? Can you see me? Can you see me as a Roman with my head unbowed? Sing it good and loud. Like a Roman having rights and like a Roman proud. Can you see me? Can you see me a reformer fighting graft and vice? Sing it soft and nice. While I'll be so conscientious that I may vote twice. Can you see me? Can you see me? When I'm free to be whatever I want to be. Think of wonders I'll accomplish then. When the master that I serve is me and just me, can you see me being equal with my countrymen? Can you see me being pseudoless the citizen? Can you see me being give it to me once again? Yes! That's it! No, not so fast. I didn't think. The way I am, I have a roof, 3 meals a day, and I don't have to pay a thing. I'm just a slave and everything's free. If I were free, then nothing would be free. And if I'm beaten now and then, what does it matter?
Free.
Can you see me? Can you see me as a poet writing poetry? All my verse will be
free.
A museum will have me pickled for posterity. Can you see me?
I can see you.
Can you see me as a lover, one of great renown, women falling down?
Free?
No, but I'll buy the house of Lycus for my house in town. Can you see me? Can you see me? Be you anything from king to baker of cakes. You're a vegetable unless you're free. Such a little word, but oh, the difference it makes. It's a necessary essence of democracy. It's a thing that every slave should have the right to be. And I soon will have the slave to write a slave for me. Can you see him? Well, I'll free him. When a pseudolist can move, the universe shakes. But I'll never move until I'm free. Such a little word, but oh, the difference it makes. I'll be pseudolist, the founder of a family. I'll be pseudolist, the pillar of society. I'll be pseudolist, the man, if I can only be free.
Free.
Spell it.
F-R-E-E.
Oh, no, the long way.
F-R-E-E.
Free.
Thank you. And it's funny because that's the first Stephen Sondheim show that he did the lyrics and the music to. And like, it's a little old fashioned. Like, it's not like what you usually put with Stephen Sondheim, but like, you can see it a little bit with the song. And it was just so great to watch you perform it. Thank you so much. All right, up next, we have another live performance. We have Brianna Galligan, who will be performing Send in the Clouds from A Little Night Music. So Brianna, what made you pick this one?
So this was the role that I had to do the most research on. And it was the role that I submitted this song as a joke, because I was like, I'm not going to get this role. And then Amanda cast me and I went, oh, shoot. So that was fun. The other thing is that I totally forgot Les Mis. We did it, but I like this song. I mean, I don't forget we did it in the last year.
Yeah, it was a long year.
It's been a long year. But this is a dream role of mine that hopefully in the future I get to play. So
yay. Oh, yeah. And guest directing credit for this one goes to Amanda Jones. Yay! So here we go, Brianna. So excited to hear you sing. I haven't heard you sing in a while. I miss it. So take it away.
Here we go.
Isn't it right? Are we a pair? Me here at last on the ground, you in midair. Send in the clouds. Isn't it bliss? Don't you approve? One who keeps tearing around, one who can't move. Where are the clouds? Quick, send in the clouds. Just when I'd stopped opening doors, finally knowing the one that I wanted was yours, making my entrance again with my usual flair, sure of my rights, no one is there. I thought that you'd want what I want, sorry, my dear. But where are the clouds? Quick, send in the clouds. Don't bother, they're here. Isn't it? Isn't it clear? Losing my timing this late in my career. And where are the clouds? There ought to be clouds.
Thanks.
Thank you. They were breaking my heart, but like in a good way. I love you. Oh my gosh, Brianna, I missed you. You're wonderful. Thank you so much. I don't know if anyone saw the Grammys last night. I didn't, but I just saw on YouTube, they did a little tribute for the In Memoriam. And then it was a bunch of Broadway people singing Somewhere from West Side Story for Sondheim. But Cynthia Erivo was also singing a little bit of that as well in the little interludes. And it was just so beautiful. Thank you. All right. Next, we're going to keep on with the little night music. It's getting a lot of love tonight. Tammy Peters submitted a Smule from it. She submitted A Weekend in the Country. So we'll get to see a bunch of much more amazing performers that were part of this reading. So here we have A Weekend in the Country from A Little Night Music.
Look, ma'am, an invitation here, ma'am, delivered by hand, and ma'am, I noticed the stationery's engraved and very grand.
Petra, how too exciting, just when I need it. Petra, such elegant writing, so chic, you hardly can read it. What do you think? Who can it be? Even the ink, no, here, let me. Your presence, just think of it, Petra, is kindly. It's at a chateau, requested, etc., etc. Madame Leonora. Weekend in the country.
We're invited.
What a horrible plot. A weekend in the country.
I'm excited.
No, you're not.
A weekend in the country. Just imagine.
It's completely depraved.
A weekend in the country.
It's insulting.
It's engraved.
It's that woman. It's that Armfeld.
Oh, the actress.
She's a fool. She may hope to make her charm felt. But if man, if she thinks it to be such a fool as to weekend in the country.
How insulting.
I have nothing to wear.
A weekend in the country.
The last place I'm going is there.
Guess what? An invitation.
Guess who begins with an A? Armfeld, is that a relation to the decrepit Desiree?
Guess when we're asked to go, sir? See, sir, the date's there. Guess where? A fancy chateau, sir.
Guess too, with lying in wait, they're setting her traps, fixing her face.
Darling, perhaps a change of pace. A weekend in the country would be charming, and the air would be fresh.
A weekend with that woman.
In the country.
In the flesh.
I've some business with her mother.
See, it's business!
No doubt, but the business with her mother would be hardly the business I'd worry about.
Just a weekend in the country, country.
Smelling jasmine.
Watching little things grow.
A weekend in the country.
Go. My darling, we'll simply say no.
A weekend.
How very amusing.
A weekend.
But also inept.
A weekend. Of course we're refusing.
Au contraire, you must accept.
Oh no!
A weekend in the country.
But it's frightful.
No, you don't understand. A weekend in the country is delightful if it's planned. Wear your hair down and a flower. Don't use makeup, dress in white. She'll grow older by the hour and be hopelessly shattered by Saturday night. Spend a weekend in the country.
We'll accept it.
I had a feeling you would.
A weekend in the country. Yes! It's only polite that we should.
Good.
Well?
I've an intriguing little social item.
Well?
Out at the Armfeld family mess.
Well, what?
Merely a weekend, still I thought it might amuse you to know who's invited to go, this time with his pants.
You don't mean...
I'll give you three guesses.
Wouldn't.
Reduce it to two.
It can't be.
It nevertheless is...
Hagerman.
Right, score one for you.
Aha.
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 A weekend in the country. We should try it.
How I wish we'd been asked.
A weekend in the country. Peace and quiet.
We'll go masked.
A weekend in the country.
Uninvited. They'll consider it odd.
A weekend in the country. I'm delighted.
Oh my God.
And the shooting should be pleasant. If the weather's not too rough. Happy birthday. It's your present. You haven't been getting out nearly enough. And a weekend in the country.
It's perverted.
Pack my quiver and bow.
A weekend in the country.
Yet. Exactly 2:30 we go.
We can't.
We shall.
We shan't.
I'm getting the car and we're motoring down.
Yes, I'm certain you are, but I'm staying in town.
My boots, pack everything.
I know.
Now it's wonderful.
There's no to shout.
We are a
weekend in the country, while we're losing our control. A weekend in the country, how we're chanting on the mannequin lungs. A weekend in the country, with the panting and the yawns. And the crickets and the pheasants, and the orchards and the hay, with the servants and the peasants, when we lay our heads and we'll play croquet for a weekend in the country, so inactive that one has to lie down. A weekend in the country,
the bees in their hives, the shallow worldly figures, the frivolous lives, the devil's companions know not whom they serve. It might be instructive to observe.
Guys, that was great. Great job, and what an incredible cast. Thank you, Tammy, for submitting that Smule. All right, next we have a Smule submission from Courtney James, who submitted You Can Always Count on Me from City of Angels. And Brianna Galligan actually directed this reading. Brianna, do you want to hop on and maybe just say a little bit about the show? If you can, yep. Since I don't know it that well, you can introduce it.
Sure. So City of Angels is an amazing play that takes half place in black and white and half in color, because half of it is a make-believe world created by this writer. And it's, yeah, his alter ego Stone is a detective. It's a film noir type of thing. It's a great show, and it's getting edited right now. So it'll be posted on the Facebook page. But yeah, Courtney was absolutely stunning and amazing in her dual parts, because each person is a character in black and white and in color. So it's really exciting.
Yay, thank you. All right, here we have You Can Always Count on Me from City of Angels.
A long line of good girls who choose the wrong guy to be sweet on. A girl with a face that says welcome, that man can wipe their feet on. I'm there when he calls me the trusted Girl Friday. All right, but what good does it do me alone night? If you need a gal to go without salary and work too hard, you can always count on me. The kind of a pal to slip you a file past the prison guard, loyal to the nth degree.
a girl cause she could type. I'm no femme fatale, but faithful and true as a Saint Bernard. Barking up the wrong damn tree. You can always count on me. I don't need a map, I naturally head for the dead end street. You can always count on me. I'm caught in a trap when joy is approaching and I retreat. I'm at home with misery. I've been the other woman since my puberty began. I crashed the junior prom and met the only married man. I'm always on tap for romance or chocolate that's bittersweet. You can always count on me. A matter of fact, if you want an ill-fated love affair, you can always count on me. Though I've made a pact to carry out research before I care, men don't give a warranty. Joe, who swore he's single, got me sort of crossed the beast. I woke up only slightly shocked that I'd defrocked a priest. Or else I attract the guys who are longing to do my hair. You can always count on me. I go for the riffraff who's treating me so-so. When I can play the second fiddle, though you can bet there's strings attached. Though my kind of dame no doubt will die out like the dinosaurs, you can always count on me. I'm solely to blame, my head gives advice that my heart ignores. I'm my only enemy. I choose the kind who cannot introduce the girl he's with. There are lots of smirking motel clerks who call me Mrs. Smith. But I've made a name with hotel detectives who break down doors. Guess who they expect to see?
Thank you, Courtney. Oh, thank you so much. You're always so engaging. So Courtney, if you watch this, thank you so much. You're always so much fun to watch. And I don't know the show, but that was awesome. So thank you so much for submitting it. All right. So next, I have a Smule from a reading that I directed. And it's from Fiddler on the Roof. And this was in August, which was the first month that we switched to just one reading a month. And I was blessed with such an incredible cast for this show. I was worried because it has a huge cast, but no regrets there doing that reading. It was so, so, so great. And the one that I'm not showing is Tradition, just because I did post that one on the Facebook page and that was amazing. It has everyone in it, but I didn't get to show everyone Matchmaker, Matchmaker, which is one of my favorite songs in the show. So I wanted to feature that in our cabaret tonight. So for Matchmaker, Matchmaker, we have Becca Cooley, Michelle Moses Eisenstein, and Keely Borland performing, again, an amazing song from Fiddler on the Roof. Oh, I think I'm in it too. Yeah, I'm in it too because I played like the smaller sisters, but it's mostly them because they're amazing and that's an amazing song for the three of them. So here we go.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a fine, catch me a catch. Matchmaker, matchmaker, look through your book and make me a perfect match.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, I'll bring the veil. You bring the groom, slender and pale. Bring me a ring, for I'm longing to be the envy of all I see.
For Papa, make him a scholar.
For Mama, make him rich as a king. For me, night after night in the dark, I'm alone, so make me a match of my own.
Huddle, oh huddle, have I met a match for you? He's handsome, he's young, all right, he's 62, but he's a nice man, a good catch, true, true. I promise he'll be happy, and even if you're not, there's more to life than that, don't ask me what.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, you know that I'm still very young. Please, take your time.
Up to this minute, I misunderstood that I could get stuck for good.
Dear Yenta, see that he's gentle. Remember, you were also a bride. It's not that I'm sentimental. It's just that I'm terrified. Matchmaker, matchmaker, plan me no plans. I'm in no rush, maybe I've learned. Playing with matches, a girl can get burned. So bring me no ring, groom me no groom, find me no find, catch me no catch, unless he's a matchless match.
Yay. That song makes me always do this. So thank you, ladies, for your wonderful performance in the reading. It was nice to see it again. All right, and here we have one, another live performance. It is from our reading of The Producers, which I still think, I don't know, I can't pick favorites, but it's definitely one of the readings where I laughed out loud, probably one of the most times. Oh my gosh, it was amazing. And one of the reasons is this guy right here. So Stephen was an amazing Max Bialystock for our reading of The Producers. And if anyone knows that show, they all know that there's like that amazing number towards the end where he goes betrayed, and it's just like, it's just so amazing. And the fact that you did it, and you did it as well as you did live during the reading, I don't even think like there wasn't any like mess ups or anything when you did it for the reading either, were there?
Yeah, we'll see how this goes tonight.
it's really amazing though. So that was a really fun reading, and I think Amanda's gonna help Stephen out for this one too with some lines in the beginning. And Amanda was in this reading too, and she did an incredible job as Roger DeBree, which was so fun. So here we go, take it away.
Okay, Amanda, you ready?
Ready.
Okay, here we go.
Mail call. Here you go, Bialystock. You got a postcard.
A postcard? From where?
Brazil.
Brazil? Who do I know in Brazil? Dear Max, Rio is everything you said it was and more. Ula and I think of every chance we get. In the morning, when we have breakfast on a terrace, many different herrings. And in the evening, when we summit together in the moonlight. Sorry, must run. Ula's waiting. It's almost 11. Wish you were here. Leo! Just like Kate and Abel, you pulled a sneak attack. I thought that we were brothers. Then you stabbed me in the back. Betrayed. Oh boy, I'm so betrayed. Like Samson and Delilah, your love began to fade. I'm crying in the hoosegow, you're in Rio getting laid. Betrayed. Let's face it, I'm betrayed. Boy, have I been taken. Boy, I'm so forsaken.
I should have seen what came to pass. I should have known to watch my ass. I feel like Othello. Everything is lost. Leo is Iago. Max is double-crossed. I'm so dismayed. Did I mention I'm betrayed? I used to be the king, but now I am the fool. A captain without a ship. A rabbi without a shoe. Now I'm about to go to jail. There's no one who will pay my bail. I have no one who I can cry to. No one I can say goodbye to. I'm drowning. I'm drowning here. I'm going down for the last time. I see my whole life flashing before my eyes. I see a weathered old farmhouse with a white picket fence. I'm running through the fields of alfalfa with my collie, Rex. Stop it, Rex. I see my mother standing on the back porch in a ward, but clean gingham gown, and I hear her calling out to me, Alvin, don't forget your chores. The wood needs a cordon and the cows need a milking. Alvin, Alvin. Wait a minute. My name's not Alvin. That's not my life. I'm not a hillbilly. I grew up in the Bronx. Oh, Leo's taken everything, even my past. My past, a dying ember. But wait, now I remember. How did it begin? He walked into my office with his cockamamie scheme. You can make more money with the pop and with the hit. We can do it. We can do it. I can't do it. We can do it. I can't do it. Goodbye, Max. Oh, I want that money. I'm back, Max. Come on, Leo. We can do it. Step one, find the play. See it, smell it, touch it, kiss it. Hello, Mr. Lincoln. Goon, goon, tuck, 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 goon, tuck, tuck, tuck. Adolf Elizabeth Hitler. Goon, tuck, 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 goon, tuck, tuck, tuck. Step two, hire the director. Keep it gay, keep it gay, keep it. Two, two, three, two, kitchen, kitchen, hula. Oh, wah, 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 wah. Step three, raise the money. Intermission. Step four, hire all the actors. A one who needs to lighten up strings. And next, a little wooden boy. Next, that's our Hitler. Opening night. Good luck, good luck, good luck. Break a leg. I broke my leg. Springtime for Hitler and Germany. A surprise smash. Springtime for Hitler and Germany. It'll run for years. Where did we go right? Where did we go right? Give me those books, fat, fat, fatty. Give me those books, fat, fat, fatty. Books, fat, books, fat, books, fat, books, fat. Lousy fruit, kill the actors. You ever eat with one? Then you ran to Rio and you're safely out of reach. I'm behind these bars, you're banging hula on the beach. Just like Julius Caesar, who was betrayed by Brutus. Who think an accountant could turn out to be my Judas? I'm so dismayed. Is this how I'm repaid? To be betrayed. Betrayed!
Woo! He did it again! Great
Thank
job.
Thank you, Tabitha, for 2 years of awesomeness. Thank you, No Place Like Home.
Aw, thank you too, Stephen. Thank you for 2 years of Stephen. Doing wonderful performances like that. I can't think of, is there another musical theater show where like at the end one character goes through the whole show like that? Like speed through?
Let me get back to
I can't think of any, but it's
I'll
amazing.
Yeah, I know.
Great job, Stephen. You're wonderful.
Thank you.
Ooh, maybe. True, but Stephen did it in singing form. I mean, it's amazing. All right. So next, I actually have two more. I was going to do only one more, but then I thought of a better finale. So the next one that I'm going to show is from our reading of Les Mis that we did in May. So it was in the beginning part of this past year. And it's One Day More, just because you have to. And Les Mis is special to me just because it was so scary. I put it off for a long time. People were begging for it for a long time. And I was like, and finally I was like, okay, let's do it. And I had an incredible, incredible cast. And it was just so amazing. And we had 2 weeks for that one. And I think it's still the one with the record of the most mules. I know Phantom and Falsetto has come very close, but it's has the most mules. I think it's 40. We did 40 mules, I think. It was some crazy number like that. But here we have One Day More from Les Mis. So please enjoy.
One day more, another day, another destiny, this never-ending road to Calvary. These men who seem to know my crime will surely come a second time. One day more.
I did not live until today. How can I live when we are parted?
One day more.
Tomorrow you with you, my world has started.
One more day all on my own.
Will we ever meet again?
One day with him not caring.
I was born to be with you.
The life I might have known.
And I swear I will be true.
If you would have told me when I first started the group that we would ever be able to pull something off like that, I would not have believed you. Not just the singing, but like the costumes and like people had guns. Like, what the heck, you guys? Like, what are you guys doing? We had 2 weeks and we did Les Mis. What's wrong with you guys? You're all amazing. So that's why when anyone ever thanks me for this group, I'm like, you have no idea how much it's about. It's because of everyone else. It's literally, I nowhere near ever thought we'd get half as amazing as you guys turned it into. Just, you're all incredible. And nights like today really remind me just how lucky I am to know all of you. And as our finale, it's funny because it's been 2 years, but honestly, the beginning of COVID actually does feel kind of like a long time ago right now, at least to me. But something that really shocked me is just 1 year ago, we had our Rent anniversary celebration, which is one of the most magical nights of my life. It was just so amazing. So much love was shared on that day. And I think that shocks me a little more than the 2 years, because that doesn't feel like a year ago for some reason to me. The 2 year makes sense to me, but the 1 year doesn't for some reason. So one of my favorite things about that reading, and it was more of a concert, less of a reading, but it was so much fun. We had like 50 people in it. It was so great. And one of the most amazing things is we got as many people as possible to join a smule of Seasons of Love. And that would not have been possible without two people, Nicole D'Angelo, who is amazing, one of the first people to ever join the group. And she really helped turn it into what it is. Nicole D'Angelo music directed that. And you know, it gets intense when you need a music director for a concert Smule Zoom reading. And she joined, she made three different Smules and she led three different harmony parts for that one. And then Bob Gadowskis, another amazing member of our group that helps out so much. He helped edit them all together and synchronized the sound of all three Smules that we created. And he was able to edit it together with this amazing final product that we made 1 year ago. So this was celebrating our 1 year anniversary last year, but it still holds true this year. And it's just amazing to see all of those incredible faces. And thank you all so much for being part of this. And here we have Seasons of Love from our 1 year anniversary celebration of Rent.
Measuring love.
And that's what I think of when I think of this group, not just the amazing harmonies and the amazing costumes and amazing singing, but just the love that we all share with each other and how lucky we all are to know each other and to have, whether you've been in only one reading or a whole bunch, we are so lucky to have had you as part of our amazing group. Thank you to everyone who submitted a SMUL for tonight and who performed for us tonight as we got to celebrate our second year. That did go a lot faster for me, at least, than our first year did, which might be a good thing. So thank you all so much, and I hope you have a wonderful night and hope to see you either virtually or